So in the first video I have said the resolving power of a grating, and in this video you will study what is the resolving power of a telescope. Okay, so telescope, and we try to see the distant object, correct? So if it is a single object, there is no problem, we get a image of a single object only. But if there are two objects are there, okay, at a far distance, but they are very very close and you cannot separate them with the naked eye. So when you are observing it through the telescope, when you are looking at with the telescope, in the images you will always get the images of any object, right? So in the images you will get the two images, okay, the images of the two objects which are very very close together. Otherwise with the naked eye you cannot separate them, but the telescope has the ability to resolve the images of the two point objects which are at a far distance. That's its resolving power. Okay, so just see how to understand this. Suppose that this is one object you have and here another object. Okay, this is the same thing. So from this, you know, the ray comes from one object and incidents at a point A, but the other ray which is coming from the other object, you know, makes an angle d theta with the direction of the ray coming from the first object. Okay, so this is your first object and this is the second object. Okay, same thing, the ray from the first object will incident, okay, it will travel like this, and ray from the second object, many rays are coming, it's not only the two rays, are making an angle d theta and incidents at a point B. This is a telescope, this is the your telescope objective. Is it clear to you? So this is the telescope, okay, meaning this is what is the objective of the telescope. Okay, so the diffraction takes place at the objective, okay, A, B, right? And you know, the ray which is coming from one object, ray which comes from one object will meet at a point P1, okay, and from the same object all the rays which are coming from the first object, they are meeting at a point P1, okay, and you get the central maxima at a point P1. Okay, that means you get the image of the first object. You will get the image of the first object over here at a point P1. Is it clear to you? And due to the ray coming from the second object, same thing happens, but you will get the image of the second object at a point P2. You can see here, this is, you know, these rays are meeting at a point P1. What it means? These two rays are meeting in phase at a point P1, and you get the image of the first object. And the rays which are, you know, going in this direction, you can see here, this and this are meeting at a point P2. So these two are the rays corresponding to the rays coming from the second object. They meet at a point P2, okay, in phase. So you get the image of the second object at a point P2, and you get the image of the first object at a point P1. Okay, so if you see the pattern, okay, if you see the diffraction pattern, you can see here, this is, you know, you can see this is the your first one, okay, diffraction pattern of the first object, you know, due to the first object, and the rays are meeting at a point P1, is you get a central maxima at a point P1. For the second one, you get a central maxima at a point P2. Okay, so the minima of the second one is coinciding with the maxima of the first. Okay, and minima of the first one coincides with the maxima of the second one. That is as per the Rayleigh's criteria of resolution. If it happens, then we can say that the two rays are, you know, the two images are just said to be resolved as per the Rayleigh's criteria of resolution. Okay, so now we come to the what is the expression for resolving power of a telescope. Okay, so here, listen to me very clearly. These two rays are meeting in phase at the point P1. Okay, but minima of the first one is at the point P2. Correct? That means there is a path difference between the ray which is going from the point A and from the point B when they meet at the point P2. Okay, not due to the second one, it is due to the first one. So if I drop a perpendicular like this, your BC is the path difference. Okay, and that path, this is d theta. Okay, so the sine of d theta will be is equal to this aperture width is a
AB, you know, AB is the aperture of the telescope and that is A. Okay. So, this is A into sin d theta is equal to BC divided by A. Therefore, BC is equal to AB sin d theta. And since d theta is very small, sin of d theta, you can replace it as A into d theta only. Okay. And now we'll come to the condition. If this A d theta is equal to lambda. Okay. If A into d theta is equal to lambda. Okay. You know that. This we have discussed it. So, if it is, you know, the wave coming from the point A and from the point B. If the path difference is lambda, I can divide this into two parts. So, from here and from here, it is lambda by 2. From here and here, it is lambda by 2. And the secondary wavelets which are going from the first half and from the second half, they are getting cancelled each other. And at the point P2, you will get a minima. Okay. So, that's the minima of the first image. But maxima of the second one. Okay. So, A into d theta is equal to lambda. Right. Therefore, d theta is equal to lambda by A. Followed, no? So, this 1 over d theta, pay that. This is the angular separation between, d theta is the angular separation between the two objects. Is it clear? That's the thing it is shown here, d theta. Okay. So, this d theta, correct expression for 1 over d theta, okay, is equal to 1 over d theta is equal to A by lambda. And this 1 over d theta is the resolving power of a telescope. Okay. So, I'll write it over here. Resolving power of a telescope is equal to 1 over d theta, that is the angular separation, reciprocal of the angular separation between the two objects which are at far distance, is a resolving power of a telescope, which is equal to A upon lambda. But the correct expression is, there is a small correction for this expression. It is 1 point, that's equal to A upon 1.22 lambda. Is it clear to you? So, that's the resolving power of a telescope. This 1.22 factor comes for the correction. Okay. So, the reciprocal of the angular separation between the two objects is called the resolving power of a telescope. Okay. So, this is the expression for RP of a telescope. A upon, that's correct, A upon 1.22 lambda. Okay. So, very simple one. If the small short question comes, you must be able to write it, that discuss the or explain the RP of a telescope. Okay. And the some problems, the certain problems on RP of telescope, I'm already, you know, I will send it on the group, okay, as a notes. You can simple problem, okay. You can, you know, solve problems, you can go through those problems, okay. So, this completes RP of a telescope.